Hello friends, I hope you are doing great. Now let's learn about the great Mughal emperor named Jahangir. Hope you enjoy and learn something new. Next in line, we have Jahangir. Jahangir was the fourth Mughal emperor who ruled from 1605 until his death in 1627. Jahangir was known for his ambivalent stance on religion and his love for art. His imperial name means conqueror of the world, world conqueror, or world Caesar. In 1622, Jahangir sent his son, Prince Khurram Mirza Jahangir, to fight against the combined forces of Ahmednagar, Bilapur, and Golconda. After his victory, Khurram turned against his father and made a bid for power. As with the insurrection of his eldest son, Khurram Mirza was able to defeat the challenge from within his family and retain power. Early life. Prince Salim, mostly known as Jahangir, succeeded to the throne on Thursday, 3rd November 1605, 8 days after his father's death. Salim ascended to the throne with the title of Nur-ud-Din Muhammad Badshah Jahangir, and thus began 22 years reign at the age of 36. His foreign relations. In 1623, Jahangir sent his Tahvildar Khan Alam to Safavid Persia, accompanied by 800 sepoys, scribes and scholars, along with 10 howdahs, well decorated in gold, silver, in order to negotiate peace with the Abbas of Persia, after a brief conflict in the region around Kandahar. The next topic that we have is of Nur Jahan. Meher-un-Nisa or Nur Jahan occupies an important place in the history of Jahangir. She was the widow of a rebel officer, Sher Afghan, whose actual name was Ali Quil Beg. Then stabbing the fallen tiger to death, Akbar was greatly affected by the bravery of this Turkish bodyguard, which was Sher Afghan, who had saved Akbar from a tiger. The loss of Kandahar was due to Prince Khurram's refusal to obey her orders. When the Persians besieged Kandahar, Nur Jahan was at the helm of affairs. She ordered Prince Khurram to march for Kandahar, but he refused to, without any mercy. There is no doubt that his refusal was due to the behavior towards him, as she was his favoring her son-in-law, Shayar, at the expense of Khurram. This is how quite Jahangir's life went. It was a little interesting, and his son, Khurram Mirza Jahangir, finally had to fall at his feet to accept defeat in front of his father.